Welcome to the day two of the Drawing Board Lecture Series 2020. It is an honor and a privilege to be hosting this lecture series for you all here today. For those of you who have joined us new today and were not there yesterday, let me tell you quickly that we had people from seven countries joining in yesterday and over 250 students and professionals as audience. And today I'm sure the count will go higher. Before we start and I formally introduce our speaker for the evening, I'm going to tell you something about the drawing board competition. It's an international initiative taken up by Rohan Builders and Mindspace Architects since 2016 to provide architecture students with real-life design challenges in real locations. And the idea is to create a space for conversations and to bring together students, professionals, and their design ideas on a common platform. It will help instigate thoughtful research by design and, of course, suggest tangible solutions to architectural problems in known contexts. Hosted annually once in the Oxford of the East Pune city, the competition finale itself is a one-day gala and where eminent juries from different countries guide students and eventually help them become the star architects that they can be. Unfortunately, this year, the times have been testing and we couldn't do this in person. And hence, the team TDB decided to go online for the fifth edition and host all its activities virtually. This is day two of the lecture series, and we will have a third lecture on the 24th of November. And that is just one day before the D-Day of the competition jury. It's a day-long event online on 25th of November. You could get all the details on our Instagram page and also our website. The website also is hosting an online voting for our Best Viewer Choice Award entry. So you may also want to log in onto the website and vote for the best entry you think deserves to win. Before I move further, let me thank all our partners for the TDB. We have been lucky to have received unending support from our fraternity, and we have been extremely thankful to all our ecosystem partners. I would like to thank our partners for this edition of the Drawing Board Competition 2020. Matter from Goa, who have been instrumental in coming out with the publication for the Drawing Board Competition, Coffee Table Book, Bilcon Architecture Magazine, Levardist, Amazing Architecture, Spacey UX, Architecture Life, India Design World, and Dr. B.N. College of Architecture, Pune. I will quickly tell you about the 2020 challenge that we had proposed to the students, for which we got wonderful response from the students. Because of the lockdown, several construction sites were stopped and the construction workers had nowhere to go. With that as the premise, looking at the housing for these construction workers, trying to find a solution that will allow this real life scenario to be addressed and explore design solutions that will solve this long-term problem, Rohan Builders and Mindspace Architects came up with the brief for the fifth edition. The competition received tremendous response from over 14 countries and 1,300 plus registrations this year, breaking all our previous records. What has made it even more special that our jury members have agreed to do a lecture series for all of us. Yesterday, we had architect Bijoy Jain presenting his take on architecture. And today, we have Professor Tezuka presenting his works and his take on architecture as well. I'm very, very thankful to all our jurors to have taken up this opportunity and helped us come forward and present their ideas to the audience. The lecture series is an outcome of trying to do something little more than just hosting the competition on behalf of Rohan Builders. We at TDB are really obliged to each one of our jury members to have kindly agreed to do these talks. And I take privilege to introduce our speaker for day two, architect Takaharu Tezuka from Japan. Born in Tokyo, Japan, 1964, Professor Tezuka studied architecture at Musashi Institute of Technology and did his post-graduation at the University of Pennsylvania. He then went to London, where he spent 4 years working with Richard Rogers Partnership Limited. In 1994, together with his wife, he established Tezuka Architects in Tokyo. The couple's work emphasizes human activity and connectivity, as can be seen in their schools, office buildings, and also hospitals. Projects have won many international awards, including the Japan Institute of Architects Prize 2009, one of the awards for the a Global Sustainable Architecture Award 2017, and also a recent win at the World Architecture Festival 2018 for the Muku Nursery School. Architect Tezuka is a TED speaker with multiple publications to his credit. He has been teaching at the Tokyo City University since 2009, and that's where his academic interest also comes from. Welcome, Architect Tezuka, and I hand it over to you to make your presentation.
Okay, nice to be invited. But I must tell you that I hate Zoom lecture because I'm talking to computer. And always I love to talk to human. So maybe it's good if Mr. Fu, Mr. with beard, can make a
second. Yeah, that's me, Mahesh. Yeah.
I think if you can show me your face, it's much better.
Yes.
Yeah, because I need a response. I feel lonely. Yes. Okay, it's good. Okay, so if I say something funny, try to make something.
Yeah, I'll give you a response. Don't worry.
Please, thank you. Okay, so I'm going to start my lecture from this slide. And this is my boss, Yui Tezuka. And she is always in red. And because she told me to be in blue, I'm in blue all the time. And I have been in blue more than, 30 years. And you have been in red more than, 50 years. I shouldn't say her age. Okay. And the people say, you are wearing same T-shirts all the time. It's not clean. No, it's not true. I have more than 100 T-shirts exactly the same. So I'm always clean. And I'm going to show you my family. And now, when we got our daughter, we decided everything we share into yellow. So she's in yellow. And when we got our son, and we are supposed to make him into yellow as well, but my daughter didn't like to lose her color. So 3 years old, my daughter started giving him green. So we got the four colors. And they still all member are keeping just the color. And that is why I'm talking about family, is that family is where my eye is coming from. You know, there's one thing I'm proud of my office. It's not exactly big office, until just 10 years ago, we had only 10 people. Now just we are about 30, but still it's not a big office. And then we got 8 marriages in our office. And if you want to find a mate, you should come to my office. But my point is that, if you don't know normal life, you can't provide happiness to the others, because that is our job. And one of my students in Harvard University asked me the question in the lecture. You understand kids, children, infants very well. How did you learn? And I told him, do you have your girlfriend? Yes, I do. Why don't you ask her to get married? Yes, I'm about to, okay? And then eventually you have a baby. You understand it. And my point is, idea for architecture is very, very simple. Every mother understands it. But the problems always happen in architecture school. If you go to architecture school, there are serious professors. You have to think about the proportions. You have to think about orders. No, just used to think they are stupid. Don't trust the professor. It's more important to talk about human life. You should go to street and how you should see how people are eating their street food and how people are talking to each other, how they are raising children and what kids do. And that is what I teach in my university. Yeah, I've been teaching students already 25 years as a professor. So I'm a very old guy now. No, I raised only three professors and three gold medals already. Anyway, just I'm moving to my slides. No, this is not my design. This is a kind of house people used to live in after World War II. It's very, very low cost construction. Just this is how normal Japanese people used to live. And whenever I talk to a new client, I ask them, where do you go on the weekend? What do you eat? And we try to be their friend to understand their lifestyle. And the husband, Mr. Takahashi, said, oh, we spent weekend on this rooftop. Actually, he jumped out from this small window and he was showing this place. I thought he was joking. Then he said, I'm serious. He was showing this slide, but it's not exactly a safe place. I know that in India, there are some comfortable roofs. I saw some in Rajasthan district, but this is just a tile roof. And as you can see, it's not safe. There is no handrail. Ceramic tiles are falling off. So I told them, you have to be careful. And then the parents said, no, you don't need to worry because we are also going out same times. So I found out they're serious. They're having lunch and the breakfast on top of this roof on the weekend. But actually, I must say, these pictures are more than 20 years old. So it means they're over 30 years old. And the one is working for bank, and the one is working in university. So it's really old, a long time ago. And so we designed a house like this. If you are an architecture student, you understand the meaning of this section. Okay, this is the residential area. And this house is situated on the edge of the residential area, looking down the valley. And this is Holy Mountain, okay? You know, they named after the, monk who introduced Buddhism to Japan as a prince. And my point is that this roof is inclined toward this valley. And whenever I talk about this rooftop, I tell my student, don't go to McDonald's if you're having first date. Because if you are going to a McDonald's, you have to face to your new boyfriend or girlfriend, and you have to keep talking in 30 minutes. For Indian, it's easy, because if I saw many Indian movies, they keep talking 30 minutes. But Japanese cannot do that, okay? And then usually 30 minutes after, we Japanese cannot sing as the Indian people in the movie. So silence comes and it's very awkward. Then something goes wrong because you start saying wrong things. And I tell students, if you want to find a good place to have a date, go to Riverside. And close to my university, there's a river called Tama River. And there's a river bank, where you find many couples, And there interesting situation, between this couple, If you see them, they are not facing each other. They're looking down the valley, looking down the river. Of course, it's inclined. If you're sitting sideways, you roll down. So you have to face down all the time. But when you are looking not each other, silence is not awkward. It's called romantic. Okay? Secondly, you are sharing same view. So you may say, oh, there's a splash on the water. Yes, there might be a nice fish down there. That kind of stupid conversation never works in McDonald's. But if you go to that bank, you understand it. And then sloping side inclined. And then so it's easier to move on to next stage. But No, because this is a student lecture, I shouldn't go into the detail. Then my point is, you know, inclination is very important. It's not flat rooftop. It's different from the rooftop in Jodhpur. No, it's inclined. Okay. And then, how do we get out onto the roof? If you look down, if you look back this slide, they used to jump out from this window. You know, when you are doing something you are not allowed to do, usually you feel good. Okay. So if there's a door here, it's not fun at all. So we made a skylight to get out. And I think she was 7 years old, you know. Younger sister said, oh no, this is my skylight. No. Then elder sister said, I want mine. So I added another one. And the father said, oh, the one here, the bedroom is mine. And the mother said, I want one for kitchen. Oh, let's have one for toilet. By the way, you can see toilet from next door neighbor, but they don't care. And there's another one for bathroom, you know, the bathtub. And another one for family member. And then another one for guest. So we started having many skylights. They said, oh, we have lunch on top of the roof. So we have to have a table and table and bench. Of course, we can have it. They said, oh, by the way, you know, neighbors are close to each other. Okay. So on the two side, I want to have a same privacy. So we added the privacy. Maybe it's common in India, no? This kind of things. But you know, except India, you don't see this kind of things. Okay. And they said, okay, we're going to have a lunch. So we have to have a kitchen. Okay, we can have a kitchen. By the way, if you have having wall, I need to think about this. And the wife said, my mother is living about 80 meters down this way. And I want to make sure if she's alive in the morning. So you have to cut the corner off. And then they said, winter is very cold. We have to have a stove. Okay, can have a stove. And then summer is very hot. Well, it's not as cold as hot as India, but it's about 40 degrees in summer. So we have to have a shower. So we had a shower. So we got this, okay? And this house was extremely well published. Now in the school book, so all Japanese students know about this house, okay? And there's a very peculiar thing about this house. There is no handrail. Actually, I was drawing handrail, but the owner is registered to giving permission to give the construction. He's on the government side. He said, why do we need to have a handrail? If you look around, look at this. No house has handrail on top. If you look around the barrier, no house has handrail. And if you go to the house we used to live in, we are living, there's no handrail on top. And why do we have to have it? So somehow he convinced me. So we designed it. And this house became so famous. And now, I know young generation who used to look at the school book became architect, because this is more than 20 years ago, okay? And they wanted the same. And then they make a drawings with the people on top, and they go to, you know, local government to get the permission for construction. Of course, they say no. But always they have a picture of this house, you know, this project, okay? This is a school book. And why can't we do this? And all they say that, oh, we know this house. That's the reason why you can't do it anymore. So it's original. You can't do it anymore. And it's original, only one. Nobody can do it. Anyway, this is a rooftop. And we are not sure if we use it, but actually they're using it. And you know, Japanese magazines are very, very serious. You know, GA and the Japan Architect, Neighbor SU, they're very serious. And they have more than 90 years of history. And when we publish this, they put people on top. And usually Japanese architecture magazines don't put people because they think you know, people are not pure. No, it's not good for architecture design. But the editor said, oh, human are very important. Without this family member, this project has no meaning. So they published human in architecture for the first time in their history. And after this, you can see many, but this is the first. And usually there's a critique right about the last issue, next issue, okay? And one of the critique, mean critique said, oh, this rooftop is very hot in summer, very cold in winter. I don't think it's used. It's a kind of fiction. He shouldn't do such a kind of things. But for the first time in the history, client wrote back to the magazine. We use rooftop, you know, we eat lunch. You know, you say, you know, rooftop is very hot in summer, of course. So you should use the rooftop before sunrise. It's cool, it's cool. And winter, after lunchtime, it's warm enough. So instead of, changing, climate, you can choose the timing. That is a very, very strong statement. So actually this statement became very, very famous. Many architectural students know about this. It's awful kitchen, don't design something like this because no money. So just a carpenter found this thing in the backyard, they put it on. But the gas company refused to bring the gas to the rooftop. Okay, they said out of question. No? And then this shower, if we are not sure if they're gonna use it, and one day we got the call from Mrs. Takahashi to my wife, Yui Tezuka. Yui-san, it's nice to take hot shower in cold typhoon. And Yui said, oh, you have to be careful. And Mrs. Takahashi said, oh, don't worry, I'm wearing t-shirts. I don't think she understood what we are worried about, at least, but we know, you know, they're using it. They go up and down. It looks like an old game. You feel like you're getting a hammer to hit your head down, okay? And if you're sitting on the edge, you see legs from underneath. So this house became so famous, and then suddenly you got the call from this kindergarten, okay? I want to design new kindergarten. And I went there and I found out, you know, wow, just feeling so good. Now architectures are so awful, but I found out, you know, it's so outdoor. You know, these days, Japanese kindergartens are quite well equipped, very modern, very, very boring, it's clean. But this was really shanty. And then you have to get out all the time to go to the next room. I felt so good. So I told him, okay, it's awful building, but it suits you. And so you should live with it. So he really got upset. So he tried to show all the leaking points and said, you know, I have to get the new building. So it was a really big, became very opposite situation. So he tried to make idea. This movie was taken long after the construction, but that is how my yellow and the green are doing, running around. You know, they love to keep making circles. It's a kind of memory written in liberal cortex, in gene, you know? So we made something like this. You know, we made a circle. If you make a circle, they don't know when they should end. They keep running around. Okay, they sleep better after dark. And of course, there are trees on the way because usually we try to open up to the south because in Japan, south summer, sun is always in south side in the winter. So it's nice to have a sun. But, you know, I thought it's nice to make a circle. So trees are on the way. So, but we didn't want to cut the tree. But keeping the tree inside the classroom is not easy. So we had to keep the roots. And then we built this. And while we are designing this, we got the request from Mr. Kato, the principal. He said, I don't want the handrail. What? And I went to see a roof house. The roof house has no handrail. It's a house. It's the owner, you know. But this is a kindergarten. It's impossible. But he said, no. I don't want the handrail. And he said, how about having a net sticking out from the edge so they can catch a children falling off? It's difficult. But somehow he convinced me. So eventually I made the drawings with a net sticking out from the edge of the roof. And then we went to City Hall. And I was talking to government officials. And they looked at us. Are you insane? So we went back to Fuji Kindergarten. They said, I'm crazy. But the principal said, no, you have to go back. So and I went back. And then that time, they were listening to us. Just this is the one interesting thing I found out. There's no election to principal of a kindergarten. Not like a president, no? Principal, the family has been running this kindergarten for 70 years. And all the children has been told, you have to listen to principal carefully. You do exactly what the principal said. And now all of them, actually this is a very big kindergarten. So all of them became now the citizens of this district. And all people in the city hall, almost all, are from this kindergarten. They are trained to listen to principal. Some of them are over 40 years old, but still they are listening to principal. You know, always say 3 years old soul to go to 100 years old. So they listen to principal. They are trained. So principal, principal told us, we can't have a handrail. Well, what can we do? This is serious. So actually they made a compromise. Okay, we have to have a handrail on the edge of the roof, but you can lose the handrail around the tree. So they made a kind of excuse like this around the tree, having net around the tree. Of course, they don't care. You get more and more. Sometimes more than 40. This boy is rubbing a tree. So he's eating the tree. And he kept saying, I want just only net. But I said, it's impossible. But at the end, he accepted. It's nice. Monkeys in zoo. Feeding time. So, and when we designed this, we broke so many rules. For example, roofs, the ceiling height was supposed to be over 3 meter, but Prisa said, the kids are smaller. Why do we have to have 3 meter? I want to see the kids on top of the roof, same time as underneath the roof. So if the roof is too high, you know, you can't see the kids on top. So try to make it as low as possible, okay? And there's no wall needed between classroom because it's Montessori education. So, and so local authority said, no, we can't do this. And, but the principal said, no, government is not giving money anyway. I'm paying, so you listen to me. So we did exactly what he said, no? But of course, you know, local government complains, even the Ministry of Education, you can't do this, but they can't complain to the principal. They are scared of him. So they tease, you know, architects around. They're you know, accusing us. Then suddenly everything gets changed. You know, OECD, OECD is the one to control the money, World Bank, no? UNESCO and the UNICEF, you know, even United Nations has to talk to them because they are the boat, no? They are the boat, they are the money. And they made a section called, effective learning environment, Center for Effective Learning Environment, because they think education is a key for the world peace. So they decided to find the best school building in the world, school facility, including university, high school, kindergarten, everything. And suddenly you got a call from Ministry of Education, very high ranking, chief secretary. Something wonderful happened. There are 166 representatives from many countries. No? And we saw this United Nations. And the Fuji kindergarten, your Fuji kindergarten became the best of the best in the world. You know, there's one interesting about, Japanese government. Japanese government doesn't listen to Japanese people. They don't listen to Asian people. They don't listen to Indian either. They listen to American. They listen to European. Suddenly they said, oh, it's wonderful. And the minister came and the minister gave us a minister prize. It's a surprise. Always we're having problems. And then we went to get the prize from Paris and we got the delegates from Japanese embassy. They're very, very nice to us. And then when we came back, we found out and my wife partner became the one to set up a new standard for the kindergarten. It's great. Now we can do what we want. Because if we want something new, just I need to ask my wife over the dinner. Okay, by the way, okay. Now, I'm gonna show you some interesting slides. This is how drops rain. You know, just in Japan, rains every day in certain season. We rain quite a lot, sometimes 100 millimeter, 200 millimeter per day. It's a very rainy country. So it's lots of water. This is normal water tap. This is the one to spray the water to your friends. Shower. He's not washing his boots. He's putting water into his boots. Now, this is a very important slide. Until this stupid COVID-19 thing happens, we used to have many visitors. Usually more than 1,000 from outside of Japan every month. Sometime we used to have more than 40,000 visitors in 1 year. It's not Disneyland. This is just a kindergarten. Just only registered people can come in, but exceeded the 40,000. And many of them are very serious. One day, we got a serious German professor. She said, this corridor is outdoor, okay? If it is raining, they might get wet. What did you do? And the principal said, in Japan, when they get wet, they change, okay? And then, even they change, they get wet, what would you do? The principal said, in Japan, usually kids are waterproofed. You can wash them clean. What did you do in Germany? It's very simple. They are worried about the temperature. Actually, in summer, 40 degrees. In the winter, -2 or -3. Sometimes snows. But their thinking was very simple. In summer, you go to the beach. The sand of the beach is 50 degrees. Japanese are very, very diligent people. They go to the beach in summer. So hot time, we go to even hotter place. In summer, we go to skiing. Ski in resort is -20. So in the cold time, we go to cold place. that's human. So we don't need to worry about too much, okay? And secondly, you know, there's no autism happening. You know, it's sometimes some autism related to the distance between people. But in this kindergarten, if this boy doesn't like this classroom, we let them go. He said, it's okay. It's circle, so eventually he comes back. It's very simple. And also, there's one more interesting thing I need to tell you. By the way, this is about the waterproof kids. Waterproof. Rainy day, they don't stay inside. Waterproof the kids. I did one more thing. I'm sorry about noise. You know, this is not Japan. This is Bali Island in Indonesia. I recorded this in Indonesia. And when we recorded, we are not aware of this beep, background noise, okay? We are just recording ritual. And then when we played this back in Tokyo, we found out there's so much noise. What is this? What is this? And the scientist who invited me explained, you know, in jungle, you have a noise cancelling system in your brain. So you can erase the background noise in jungle. But back in Tokyo, you are disconnected from jungle. So you can't erase it. And also, you should know that you are doing exactly the same about your body. Your heartbeat, breathing, are making huge noise. But you are erasing it. But once you dive underwater, you get disconnected from the rest of the world. You can hear heartbeat and the breathing, okay? That's human. So if you are in a very quiet room, you can listen to your body noise. Now just there's a theory that is causing lots of problem for the kids. Because in modern school building, we have more autism happening. ADHD, ADHD, those kind of things, you know? Because they can listen to both their body noise. And I wrote about this kind of things in the United Nations, but today I don't have time to read it out. So I hope you can find it. And also there's this paper by medical doctor. And they're saying, if you put a newborn baby in special room, very quiet conditions, they get the mental disorder. So don't do it. And if you put them back into noisy, just newborn baby room, they sleep in noise. You know, if you are parents, you know that, you know, kids sleep very well in the hand of in a parent, even restaurant. When we want them to eat, they are sleeping. And when you put them into quiet room, they start screaming. You know, because in silence in jungle, as a sign, predator. Are coming to eat, a predator is coming to eat you, okay? So it's simple, okay? Now, this is a book about this kind of things. So you can find it on Amazon. Do you have Amazon in India? Okay, good.
Yes, we do.
Okay, maybe you can find it. This is how they divide classrooms, okay? I think I'm talking too slow, okay? They were supposed to help teacher, they don't work. This is how classroom is looking like. Very, very free plan. Wash basin, they talk each other. Christmas time, a monkey trying to fish another monkey. This is where Santa Claus comes down. It's Christmas time. This is light bulb. You know, still they are using old fashioned light bulb because they're worried about the ultraviolet light. Because the ultraviolet light is bad for their eyes. That's what they think. And they just there are more than 100 string, turn it on and off. So instead of using efficient lighting, they are trying to teach them how to be conscious about energy consumption. Now this is a movement of boy between 10 past 9 to 30 past 9. It's not exactly a small rooftop. He made this much within 20 minutes. But in the morning, he made 6,000 meters. The surprise is not yet to come. Average is 4,000 meters. So it's about 5 times of normal kindergarten.
大きな楕円形の建物.
You don't need to tell them what they should do. It's all a spontaneous movement. You know, they're moving different directions, but they're thinking about it. There's no plan to. Just like a sheep that needs to the field. They keep running like this. They're asleep. In the morning.
子供たちなんでこんなにいっぱい走るかっていうとね、子供ってね、こういうふうにこう行き止まりのないところをぐるぐる走るのが大好きですよね。この屋根の上も内側に向かってすり鉢状に傾いてるんですね。そうすると何がいいかっていうと、ほら、早く走ってもなんか外に飛び出す感じがしないでしょ。さっきと見たような感じで。なんか走りたくなるんですよ、こう斜めに。子供たちはね、それを感じるんですよね。なんかこうしなさいって言わないんだけど、走りたくなる。
There are more than 20 windows on top of the roof. The children love to jump into the net. There are 3 trees. Sometimes we get more than 120 children around the tree.
So just need to show slide very quickly because I have of course, so now just we as a government, we can do whatever we want. We put the 7 roofs. 7 floors is within 5 meters. This English language classroom. When we do these kind of things, we need to make sure it's safe. So we put the yellow and the green kids. And he hit his head. He's okay. He's my son. He's quite resilient. And we test with him. And then we put the kids. Awful traffic. Tokyo. But they learn each other in this kind of situation. Okay. No furniture inside. From here, I start moving my slide very quickly. And this is a bit more serious project. You know, tsunami came. You know, this is a size, amazing size. And there's a lady holding microphone to the end, telling, leave the town, and she died. And then another, you know, hero, he kept saying, if earthquake happened, come to my temple. Because temple has been there a long time. And these trees were 400 years old. Because last tsunami at 1611. This time, 2011. Tsunami comes like a clockwork, 400 years. So we are supposed to know it's coming. And tsunami came so far. This is already a few kilometers away from the coastline. Tsunami came this far, 20 meters from sea level. And all trees died because the ground was soaked. Tsunami is not the wave. Water stayed half day. And we were asked to UNICEF to collaborate. So and they said, they asked us to make a temporary building. I said, we shouldn't do that. You know, it's a waste of money. We can use these trees. The huge trees, huh? Over 40 meters. And the circumference is 4 meters, 5 meters. It's not the perfect timber, but the very heavy. It's solid, 600 by 600, the columns. And we use old Japanese technique because in Japan, you know, there are many buildings, timber buildings exceeding 1,000 years. You know, in India, and most of the old buildings are stone, but in Japan, old buildings are timber. Okay, so we used old technique because I needed this building to stand more than 400 years. It's a part of a temple. Looks like a temple. The kids are back. So this column is not just a structure. Telling them, I was killed by seawater, 2011. Now, year 2411, another tsunami is going to come. And then you have to come to my temple. If earthquake happens, you have to come to me. Your life will be saved. That's a message. So now how the problem is looking like. So from 400 years from now, tsunami will come. And I will go back. And I build new kindergarten. So phase three is going to be there, 2411. I hope you can come to see this. I know that in India, okay? In next life is maybe 400 years from now, okay? Oh, by the way, you may not be a human anymore. So I'm gonna show you how it's looking like. Actually, this is how building used to be on the middle of the forest. We built this on the high ground in the forest. But people moved. It became the middle of the center of the city. Kids are resilient. So we designed this building to stand more than 400 years. The winter is very cold, minus 20, but they run around outside. Inside the air condition, very warm and the cool, and all stay same temperature. This is how kids are supposed to be. Became the center of the new city. So just I'm going to show you many projects very quickly because I don't have time. So you have to invite me again to India again. I am a very big fan of India.
We'll be more than happy to do that.
Okay. This is art project. I collaborated with a net artist, Canadian-Japanese. And then you don't need to tell them what they should do. They keep moving. This is my favorite photo. There's no furniture needed. This is very Japanese construction, Joinery. Always father is tired. My wife and my son, he's very cute. They're not like this anymore. Long time ago. And this is a project we won World Architecture Festival Prize. It looks like umbrella. And we built something like this, no indoor circulation. But neighbors are saying the gas tank. They're looking at this from above. It's not a gas tank. If you look down this, if you look this from underneath, it looks nicer, umbrella. We use the timber construction. We found out timbers are good for Japanese weather. Very humid. And the people ask us to design the donuts. So sometimes we have to design another donut. It's inclined, so to catch more sun. Very cold weather, minus 20 in the winter. But after all, what they love is space underneath. And there's another project I need to talk about. Actually, I am the client. I am the president of the museum. The concept is a dish of kids. you know, if you go to the museum, kids museum, usually you leave kids in the museum and parents go somewhere to come back. I hate that kind of situation. So I made a huge dish to put kids, you know, just a concept like a zoo. You know, we can't buy lion, we can't keep tiger, but we can keep kids inside. We slow them into, and we make interesting plans, and the kid and the parents can eat outside. Okay. My daughter is looking like this anymore now. See, this is how we work with students. And because of the COVID situation, no? You know, it's not easy to find a music hall. And the mother that thing.
これ何？小栗さんの友達？小栗さんの友達だってやりそうだけど。
You have kids? You should come to this museum. I'm the president. So this is the kind of things we do, you know. By the way, this is interesting, you know. My daughter's crying. This is what we do in the museum, okay? And, you know, there are too many projects I want to show you. This is interesting, deep in snow. You know, this is the amount of snow to go to another side. You have to make tunnel. And this is the amount of snow in one day. Our project architect said it's impossible to get the site. Tried. She said, I can't. We call it Mount Everest. But in summer, it transforms. We give market. I wish I have time to explain it. We design churches like this. Acoustic condition is very important, so just we test it all the time. By the way, there are also a couple in my office. I told them, if you don't finish a project on time, you won't have wedding. So they worked very hard. My dream is after 70 years old, I start the piano bar, okay? That is my future plan. Another church. Sorry, just to run very quickly because running out of time. This is an interesting project. You know, we are designing this building in historical district. And this area is known to have World Heritage Factory. This is the first modern silk factory in Asia. And the most important thing is that this is where labor labor laws that, you know, they are allowed to work only 7.5 hours per day, okay? And they had a weekend. It's a bit as in my office 140 years ago, okay? Now, 140 years ago, it's amazing, you know, 7.5 hours per day and the weekend, okay? And the latest medical care. So this became World Heritage with many meanings in Tomioka City. And we were told to design the, you know, Chamber of Commerce, a Chamber of Commerce and Industry of the city. But, you know, they said, we don't want just on the history. Of course, we like to have a feeling of this factory. But at the same time, this is a city of a space rocket. Because the city made a space rocket. Went to asteroid belt, picking a stone back to the Earth. So they wanted the future too. So we use a timber with monocoque structure. So very strong shape is making this building to be strong. So this side is very historical, and then we continue this shape from to another side. Another side is looking like a Millennium Falcon, okay, the future. They go in, they look back, and you see a historical building. I know there are many timber buildings these days, but we design only genuine timber building. You know, no steel structure is used. You know there are many architects using steel structure with timber on top. I don't do such a kind of things. No, you know, we do only honest merchandise, okay? So we designed too many buildings, so I can't show you all. Oh, it's another church. Sorry, maybe I should show at least this. At least I should show this.
We have the time, you could take your time and don't really explain about it.
You know, their request is going back before the Catholic, because they want to go back to original. So we made a reference to, you know, all the, you know, Egyptian temple and also a 6th century church, much darker, very deep stone. Made a reference like this. So, and this is the last project I'm going to show you. This is already almost a 16 years old project. And now this year I get the heaviest snow in the world. Sometimes snow piles up 12 meters. And we design building like this. It's not small building, 160 meter long, coated in steel, looks like a submarine. And we designed like this because it's very heavy snow. We have very big windows. You need to remember this because it has meaning. In the winter, 5 minutes, 1 hour, in a week. So if you get cold in this crevice, you have to wait until May to come out. This is already 7 meters deep. And one day we got the call. Are you sure this window is okay? Just, oh yeah, we calculated. Don't worry. They called us again. Are you sure this is okay? So I called the structural engineer, Mr. Ikeda. Are you sure this is okay? Yeah, I think it's okay. We calculated. So I told curator. They think probably okay. Then they called us again. Scary. And but it's no, actually it's just really strong. Snow stays itself. And just before snow reaches roof, beautiful light coming in. We call the light Tadaro Ando effect. Now at the end, I'm gonna show you this slide. You know, these days people are really worried about the kids get drowned, but he's 24 months old that time. He was 24 months old. And just he turned to 2 years old, he started swimming. I remember the date, 21st of June, 2007. He was exactly 2 years old. And then 10 years old, he never get drowned. He can dive up to 7 to 8 meters. Now that time he was 10 years old. Now he can swim with me more than 5 to 6 kilometers, no problem. Never get drowned. And the handrail, he doesn't need it. Anyway, so just this is the last movie I'm going to show you.
This house was built 14 years ago when my daughter was born. This side is quite long towards the south and north, and the view is north side. So we try to let the light in from the south. So we make the sole roof shape, and the sunlight comes through the skylight. Every space is one altogether. And so we have a long table like this. Everything happens around this table.
We like to design architecture for permanence. Of course, there is no permanence, but I would say continuity. Of course, we can design this greenhouse, but the house is not just about styles, the living style changes. This is a place to raise children. It's a nest, not a design.
Just recently, we made a children's rooms.
Yeah, the thing is, we're supposed to have only one bedroom, so we had to divide into three. And when we got the first child, one of my friends gave me a good comment. You know, you're going through the most beautiful moment of your life. And the time will last 10 years, and the time will never come back. And I think as we are feeling that first 10 years, how it's changed. And my son is 11 years old. It's at the time we have to separate the rooms for each members. So that's the first step of separation. But still, it's home, no? So we try to divide the rooms into three pieces with just the punches. But there are quite nice tricks between rooms. Because it's made of furniture, you can make a small window, so it can be just wall thing, so still the conversation is going on. So we try to maintain a bit of privacy and also a bit of communication all the time. We like to design a house capable of carrying memories. Usually we have to design, bedrooms for the family members. And we happen to have just only one bedroom, so we have to share everything. But we realize it's good for family. In the modern society, always there's separation between the family members. windows. But I remember, maybe it's the old Japanese member, and we used to share space in Japan's house. You know, we used to have only paper partitions. And the bedroom was supposed to be living room in daytime. So we learn how to help each other, how to talk to each other, how we can live together. And that helps us to live in Japanese society. Japan is a very small island. So if we don't cope with others, we can't live. Oneness.
I thought the house should be the kind of space they learned how to communicate and how to take care of others.
The bonding formed in this room is going to last quite a long time.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Professor Tezuka, it was a visual treat and enjoyed every bit of it, right from the school, the inclined donut to your own house. It has been a wonderful treat.
Okay.
Two words I take out from the presentation is response to the user is one thing that you have very well addressed through all your projects.
Okay.
And the feeling of oneness, the feeling of belonging to the project. So be it the kids at the school or your own kids at in your own house or the kids' museum, the play park you showed. I think everybody, the user, is has this sense of belonging, which is very important. So thank you so much for giving us this inspirational talk.
Okay.
There are a few questions which we will quickly take so that... because we have the time also, and there are so many audience questions that are popping up. They are very inspired. There are comments that say that your work is inspirational. It's a beautiful amalgamation of functionality and quirkiness. And also you have given importance to both the sides, the user and the structure as well. People also want to know about your attachment with the timber work that is typically used in Japan. Are you trained in using all these joinery that you showed us? Is the timber work more of your USP in terms of you like using it, or it got special training to use all of this?
Yeah, it's the designing timber building is not the easy thing to do. You need to know how to deal with it. But I must tell you, we are in very special situation. You know, in Japan, you know, because of the island, there are many companies stay long time. The oldest construction company in Japan is 1,400 years, run by same family. And they are more than 1,000 years old temples, more than a few hundred of 1,000 years of temples. But the main, there's no stone temple.
No stone. You know? Yeah.
So they require maintenance. And so same family, same construction companies are doing maintenance. So the accumulation of these wisdom. So you know, still there are many wonderful carpenters, and we try to keep them. I think just keeping that craftsmanship is our duty, I think.
Wonderful. There's a question about the kindergarten project that you showed. How do you ensure that the sand or the soil from the courtyard is not carried inside the classroom? Because there's high possibility of it sticking to the shoes of the kids.
It comes in, but they don't die, you know? And also you should know that, it's very important to keep the bacteria balance. I'm not sure if you know that, in Japan, the much lower percentage of people are dying because of died in this situation. I think there is something to do with the immune system. And I must say, similar things happening to India. You know, it's a corona thing. This COVID thing is becoming more serious in much more developed green country. No? I think it's even just the COVID-19 is a part of life.
Yes.
You know, we are not living alone. So, soil coming into building is a part of life. And also you should know that in Japan, we take your shoes off.
Yeah.
That is another issue. Okay. Thank you.
All right. There's a question from a student again. What kind of human activities and habits do we really consider while we design spaces? What are your observations? Because all your architecture that you kind of addressed was based on the way people utilize the space. So do you really study this human behavior first before addressing your designs?
Yes. I tell you how to learn these activities. Do barbecue, go to the market, play with kids, take care of your grandmother and grandfather, talk to your friends, and then you learn. Don't stay with a computer game in your house. Then you learn. That's the best
Very important.
Way to understand it.
There's another question that has come, which says, because you are a professor at the Tokyo City University, do you think the design teaching or the design education needs a change or needs a specific direction?
I hate to, confine the direction. I think there should be diversity. Maybe there could be a very serious school, but I don't like it, but I don't deny other kinds, okay? But there's one thing every school has to teach, that I'm certain of it. We should teach students architecture is about sharing. It's not designing your sculpture. We are giving to do huge project. We are giving to change the world. If you become some well-known architect, you get the $600 million, $1,000 million. Even I designed the highlights, okay? But it's not my money. We are given the money to something good for next generation. Our life is very short. Even you are well, if you are very careful about your health, you die outright, maybe around 100, okay? And then you have to leave something for your children and grandchildren, grand-grandchildren. That is how
True
you
that.
Should, what you should do, as an architect. That is what you should teach.
Great. Very important and very noble as well. We have a lot of questions popping in now, but I think we will write those to you and maybe you could answer them and we could host them on our website or our Instagram page later on, as we are just on time to end our talk today. Thank you, Professor Tezuka. It was an honor to see this presentation. I've seen your TED Talk as well. It's very inspirational. And the kind of work that you're doing, I'm sure, will inspire the audience today to kind of follow those ideologies while designing in India also. We have participants from all over the world today as well. So it's surely inspirational. So thank you very much. We are looking forward to have you on 25th as the jury for the main event day on the 25th of November. It's a day-long event where the top 10 entries will be presenting their design ideas and the jurors will give their crits on it. So we'll request the audience to join us on 25th of November. The links and everything is shared on our website, on our Instagram page as well. You could follow them. And there is a Viewer's Choice Award, so you could go on website and vote. And we will look forward to all the audience and also Architect Tezuka to join on 24th of November as well, where architect Rahul Gore is going to present his works from Opolis Studio. And I'm sure there's so much to take away and think about after we've seen your work today. So thank you very much, Professor Tezuka and the audience. It's been a pleasure. And we will see you all on 24th and of course on 25th as well.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you very much, sir.